Are we on the verge of World War III? That's the question. There's reports that the Chinese Navy, they're running exercises. They're actually surrounding Taiwan right now. There's some actual concern that they may invade as soon as June. If that does happen, the U.S. is going to want to pull this microchip infrastructure out of that country, out of that island, however you define Taiwan. And they're going to try to pull that out. We may be looking at a big confrontation between the United States Navy and the Chinese Navy. We'll see what happens there. If they sink one of our ships, we can end up in a world war. We're going to end up in a major war with China. So that's just one of the many concerns. Russia, they have an ultra high frequency observation post, early warning nuclear site. Something supposed to help. It's something with a range of 6,000 kilometers, supposed to help them pick up any type of nuclear threat, any type of missile threat within a certain area. And I think it's actually covering an area reaching as far as Poland or whatever. The report is that it's been damaged. It was attacked, and apparently it was the Ukrainians. That's what they're claiming. The Ukrainians were behind this. Now, this is pretty dangerous because this is an early warning system. I'm hoping that the Russians have backup systems. I'm sure they do have contingencies. They have redundancies in place. But whenever you have something this important element of your nuclear security attack, there's definitely some concern. So I don't know if they're at DEFCON 2 or the Russian equivalent, but the situation isn't looking good right now. And I'm sure a lot of you guys are trying to enjoy this 3-day weekend. But I do want to make sure you guys are aware of what's going on. So these are some of the things I think we should be focusing on. We should keep our eye out. Doesn't mean I'm not having fun and enjoying life. I saw that new Mad Max movie, Furiosa, which is pretty good. Probably a little bit longer than it really needed to be. But anyway, make sure you have plenty of freeze-dried food. Make sure you have your MREs, stuff like this. Emergency food, plenty of water. I know you guys don't like to hear a lot about this stuff, but this is a med bag filled with some pretty important items. Everything, I put some glucose in here in case it's needed for a medical emergency, some gauze, some Benadryl. Also have some gauze, quick clot. A lot of stuff designed to stop the bleeding, because if you're going to begin into firearms and stuff like that, it's going to be important to have gear that you can use to stop the bleeding. I'm not going to show you everything, but I have something for burns as well. I have a lot of stuff designed to stop the bleeding. I even have my trauma kit actually inside of this big bag. I got some scissors. One new thing I did add to this actually was, if I can get it open, was these big trauma pads. Here's my pad, fire blanket. Chest vent seal, another fire pad, trauma dressing, got about three of these in here, so gives you an idea, fire blanket, some other gear like that, more stuff in here, but just something to keep in mind. You want to have some gear for emergencies. EDC, don't wait until something bad happens to start carrying. If you have that ability in your area, I am carrying Glock 21, Glock 30, extra mags. Make sure you have battery powered radios. Really important. So really important to have that. More water, more freeze-dried food. If you gotta get canned goods, get canned goods. Get whatever works for you. This one's mostly filled with beans. But pretty heavy, but I imagine it'll be pretty useful. And also make sure you're physically able to carry a lot of this gear too. That's something to keep in mind as well. So hope you guys are preparing. Stay informed. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. So let's hope that cooler heads prevail. Let's hope we have peace between NATO and Russia. I wish you guys a peaceful, joyful 3-day weekend. Take some time to think about the people who made sacrifices for this country. And enjoy your family, enjoy your loved ones. Thanks for watching.